In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of gluteus maximus. This is gluteus maximus. It is very, very big muscle and very strong muscle. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Let's look at origin of gluteus maximus. Origin is very, very wide. The part of origin is here, is posterior part of ilium and very close to gluteal line. And imagine there is sacrum here and coccyx here. Gluteus maximus attaches on the lateral part of sacrum and coccyx. Okay? Ilium, sacrum, and coccyx. Okay, so gluteus maximus attaches on pelvis, sacrum, and coccyx. That sounds very, very important, right? If gluteus maximus gets tight, it can inhibit movement of pelvis, sacrum, and coccyx. You know, sacrum and coccyx are the axial spine. That means continuation goes up to lumbar spine, thoracic spine, and cervical spines. If this area gets tight, this can affect whole spine. Okay? Then, some anatomy books say it attaches on the fascia of gluteus medius. Gluteus medius is this muscle. So, there is a kind of here. You know, gluteus maximus covers gluteus medius, this area, so it attaches on the fascia of gluteus medius. This is also important because gluteus medius has very important role to stabilize pelvis and hip joint. Of course, it moves hip joint. However, gluteus medius has something to do with hip stabilization and pelvis stabilization. Then gluteus maximus covers gluteus medius. This is also important, right? And some anatomy books also say gluteus maximus attaches on thoracolumbar fascia. This is a fascia of lower back. There is a continuation of like this continuation. Gluteus maximus to the thoracolumbar fascia. Gluteus maximus has many fascial connections such as gluteus medius, thoracolumbar fascia, and one more structure. There is the ligament between the pelvis and sacrum, like this. This is sacrotuberous ligament. Some fibers of gluteus maximus attaches on sacrotuberous ligament. Oh my gosh, how many attachments does gluteus maximus have? There are a lot. Basically, pelvis, sacrum, coccyx, and fascia of gluteus medius, thoracolumbar fascia, and ligament. This is pretty much it. This is origin of gluteus maximus. So in next picture, let's look at insertion and function. Okay, this is closer view. This is gluteus maximus. This part is insertion. There are pretty much two insertions. This part is upper fiber insertion. This attaches on the fascia, which is this one. This is iliotibial band, also known as IT band. So upper fiber attaches on IT band. You know, this actually doesn't attach on the bone. It attaches on the fascia that affects the tension of thigh. This is also important. And this one, the inferior part, attaches on the gluteal tuberosity. It attaches on the bone. Okay? The upper fiber attaches on the fascia. Lower fiber attaches on the bone. Okay? So let's look at function. The main function of gluteus maximus are extension. extension of hip. Extension is like you kick leg backward. That's extension. And external rotation. External rotation is like you open up leg this way. You know, external rotation. This is the main function. Very, very strong hip extensor and hip external rotator. But there are few more functions. Do you remember there are upper fiber and lower fiber? What does upper fiber specifically do? It does abduction. Abduction is opening up leg this way. Abduction. Upper fiber does abduction. And lower fiber does adduction. Adduction is closing leg. Imagine if the lower fiber contracts, that brings leg this way. So there is slightly the vector of adduction. And imagine if upper fiber contracts, that brings bone this way, that makes slight vector to the abduction. Abduction and adduction. Actually, I didn't know this information until I looked up its function very carefully. I only knew the gluteus maximus did extension and external rotation. I think abduction and adduction are minor functions of gluteus maximus, but it is very good to know because gluteus maximus has so many things to do for walking, maintain the posture, or weight training. You know, this is very, very good muscle, so it's good to know very specific detail. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of gluteus maximus, its origin, insertion, and function. I hope this video helps your understanding of muscle anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.